I just love that song, Blue Skies by Maxine Sullivan. I'm here in the studio with Jessica Lee, and you're going to find out how Maxine Sullivan has influenced Jessica Lee in her performances and how she found her. We're going to do a show called The Return of the Pint-Sized Songstress, Maxine Sullivan.
I'm going to love you like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine.
High as a mountain, deep as a river, come rain or come shine.
First question of the day is, who is Maxine Sullivan?
So many people forget who Maxine Sullivan was. She was very petite. She was a singer. And they called her the pint-sized songstress. That was kind of her nickname. She was 4 feet 11 inches, and she was 85 pounds.
Wow.
Which is, you know, unbelievable that she was that little baby, and she sang over 150 albums with Louis Armstrong.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing. She was this petite little singer from Homestead, in Pittsburgh, PA. And Pittsburgh largely forgets about who she was. Maxine, the biggest thing about Maxine, other than she was so small and petite, she put the ing in swing, they say.
Sure.
The historians. And she kind of was one of the first singers to create that lilting classic jazz swing vocal style.
Now, you made a fan of me with Maxine Sullivan. I've listened to over 50 of her songs and more on YouTube and watched her videos. It's just fascinating. She sang in Japan up to 1986, and she died the next year in 1987, so her voice was still just powerful.
Well, maybe I won't live to love you as long as I want to. Life isn't long enough, baby, but I'm gonna want to as long as I live. Maybe I can't give you diamonds and things like I want to, but I can promise you, baby, I'm gonna want to as long as I live. I never cared, but now I'm scared. I won't live long enough. So why I wear my rubbers when it rains? I eat an apple every day, then see the doctor anyway. What if I can't live to love you as long as I want to? Long as I promise you, baby, I'm gonna want to as long as I live.
She started off in Pittsburgh. She moved to New York City. She sang all her life. So she gigged all her life long. And I had never really heard too much about Maxine Sullivan, which is an amazing thing because I'm this huge fan of classic jazz and crossover jazz.
And you're a huge history of jazz person. Let me just tell folks that much.
Yeah.
You tell us the history in every show of jazz singers from Louis Armstrong, Billie Holiday, Aretha Franklin.
Yes.
And this will segue into who did she influence?
Well, before we even go to who she influenced was, how did I even find her?
Yes.
You know what I mean? I'm from Pittsburgh. You would think you would hear all about her.
Right.
And two Christmases ago, I became very sick with the flu.
Okay.
I was supposed to be singing all of these jazz shows, and I had to cancel them all and sit home with the flu. And I got onto YouTube, and I started looking around YouTube for singers. I like to listen to live music when I have laryngitis and I can't talk.
Sure, I understand.
So I find Maxine Sullivan, a video of her, singing this song, Come Rain or Come Shine. I sing Come Rain or Come Shine.
Yes.
And a lot of people say there's an oral tradition in jazz, that there are regional dialects in jazz.
Sure.
So if you are influenced by people from the Pittsburgh, PA region, from jazz greats who taught you, they were your mentors, you might have some of that dialect from more of a Pittsburgh jazz.
Thanks for making that
scene,
clear.
You know?
Yes.
When I saw Maxine Sullivan singing Come Rain or Come Shine, I sing it a lot like her, and it shocked me.
Yeah.
Because maybe she could have been my coach. I was like, wow, you know? And then I was really turned on to her, and I started to research her life and found out who she influenced, and that she and Louis Armstrong did so much together to create the basic foundation of vocal jazz. And yet you know a lot about Louis, but you don't know a lot about her and who she influenced.
That is shocking.
And so what's really cool is I got to listen to her singing Come Rain or Come Shine. Then the next show I did, I came out singing a version of Come Rain or Come Shine, and I talked all about Maxine Sullivan.
Definitely. And you're going to hear Jessica Lee sing at Audible Images, Come Rain or Come Shine.
Yeah.
Like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain, deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true. If you let me, you're gonna love me like nobody's loved me. Come rain or come shine. Happy together, unhappy together, won't it be fine? Yes, days may be cloudy or sunny, we're in or we're out of the money, but I'm with you always. I'm with you, rain or shine.
Some of the people the women singers, at least,
sure,
who were influenced back by Maxine Sullivan, are the major names: Billie Holiday, Peggy Lee, Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald. So you can see she influenced many of those female vocal jazz artists who people remember easily.
Sure, sure. Yeah,
but they don't remember Maxine easily.
No, that's so interesting, because the Pint-Sized Songstress has been forgotten.
And so I decided to create this show called The Return of the Pint-Sized Songstress. And I'm pint-sized a little bit, but not as much as she was, you know. I'm about 5'4". She was 4'11".
a little more petite.
A little more petite. And I worked up a show with jazz guitar great Mark Strickland.
Yes.
To remember Maxine, to shine a light on Maxine,
sure,
to thank Maxine, because we're all kind of standing on her shoulders.
No, that's just so interesting. And I've heard you sing in numerous locations, and you're going to hear that now. So I can't wait to hear that. I'm excited and honored to do this show on the return of the Pint-Sized Songstress.
Yeah, and one of my favorite songs that kind of illustrates how Maxine Sullivan influenced those other singers like Peggy Lee that I'll perform for you,
sure,
is a version of Hallelujah, I Love Him So, which was written by Ray Charles,
okay,
and recorded by Peggy Lee.
Wow, you've tied in some legends.
Yeah, in that jazz swing vocal style.
Let me tell you about this boy I know. He's my baby, lives next door. Morning before the sun comes up, he brings me coffee in my favorite cup. That's how I know, yes, I know, Lord. Hallelujah, I love him so. Now when he calls me on his telephone, he tells me I am all alone. By the time he counts from one to four, I hear him on my door. Every evening when the sun goes down, when there is nobody else around, kisses me, holds me tight. He tells me, baby, everything is alright. That's how I know, that's how I know. Hallelujah, I love him so. Me, baby, everything. is all right. That's how I know, that's how I know. Hallelujah, I love him so. That's how I know, yeah, yeah, that's how I know. Hallelujah, I said I love him. Well, now I love him so.
And then we had another point about she was so shocking with her unique style she presented back then.
Yeah.
This was like 1937 that she started. So,
a lot of people use a term called crossover jazz today. And I'll say I do sing classic jazz and I sing crossover jazz, meaning I'm taking songs from all kinds of other genres.
Sure.
Might be folk, it might be country, it might be rhythm and blues or blues, might be funk. And do them in jazz stylings, do them in my own way. And you may recall many, many jazz greats who have, for example, recorded Beatles songs.
Sure.
And done them in their own jazz way.
They make it their own.
They make it their own. Maxine shocked people way back when because she began taking songs from folk and other cultures and doing them in the jazz swing and jazz stylings. Back then it was shocking. Today, even people think maybe that's a new thing. Really, crossover jazz has been happening for a while, and Maxine was one of the first pioneers.
Sure.
And we've talked about a particular song.
Exactly.
You know, that...
Well, like Loch Lomond.
Yes, that was a big hit for her.
From Scotland.
Yes.
So
yes.
Go figure. Here's a lady from Homestead in New York City and became an international star because of how she phrased and sang this song.
Yeah.
Just amazing.
Yeah.
That's what kind of fan you made of me.
Light. Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low road. I'll be in Scotland for you. But me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. By yon bonny bank and by yon bonny brae, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond. On the bonny, bonny bank of Loch Lomond. Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low road. I'll be in Scotland before you. But me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond.
Beautiful. I mean, I always wanted to see, I would have loved to have seen Maxine perform live. And she was to come to Pittsburgh.
Oh, really?
To perform at the Mellon Jazz Festival. I think it was 1987.
Yeah.
The year that she died.
Sure.
And she became so ill in New York City, she wasn't able to make that trip.
That's so sad.
Yeah.
What a life she had. Long life in jazz.
Singing all the way up until she went to heaven, which is my dream. That's my
good
dream.
Good luck on your dream.
Yeah.
I'm sure you'll do well.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, she's really, in a way, when you think about it, influenced all of us jazz vocalists, no matter exactly what our style is. Jazz vocals, that's a broad kind of a thing.
Sure.
When you think about, there's a book called Louis's Children about Louis Armstrong and all the different vocal stylings that he's influenced. So I think they probably would hold hands and they could do a book on Maxine and Louis together and how they influenced everybody. And she's influenced me in a couple of ways. We'll get back to the singing part, but when she went to New York, she took a little bit of time to start the Good Words Club up.
I've heard you mention that before.
Remember that?
Yes.
And she wanted to take all the children in who had an interest in really expressing themselves And she would have them look up all these different words, good words, sure, learn what they meant, and then use them in poetry and in different ways in rhythm. And she'd bring jazz players, and they'd
what
kind of do things with the guys playing behind them. Yeah,
sure.
Do poetry or certain types of vocals. So she said a lot of kids became interested in music, too, because of the Good Words Club. And I tend to do a lot of nonprofit work, as you know.
Sure.
And that inspired me, reading about her Good Words Club.
Helps reinforce what you're doing and to continue further.
How it impacted the kids.
Sure.
Yeah. And so I wrote a song called Love, No Hands, about unconditional love. And I'd like to sing a version for you.
I can't wait to hear it on this show.
As part of this show, it has the lilting jazz vocal style, Remembering Maxine.
And I've heard the song a few times, and I'm a fan of it.
Oh, thank you.
And it's a great inspirational song. Yeah. Makes you think
thank
deeply.
You. Yeah, and there's a line at the end of the bridge that talks about the teacher's touch. And I think Maxine was kind of a teacher to many,
sure. You tied
to many
that
of
in.
Us.
Sure.
Yeah.
Love no strings, love no hands, and holding on. Love, love no strings, love no hands, just touch through soul. Oh, warm and low, and a glass of wine. I wish. Against your skin, is it the softness of no strings, love no hands, no holding on. Love no strings, love no hands, just touch through.
Jessica Lee, what a great song. It sounded just awesome. You know, I'm a huge fan, and you sound better each time.
Thank
and
you.
And I'm glad we could do this song for the show.
Thank you, Al.
And you're going to be doing some Return of the Pint-Sized Songstress shows.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about when and where? I'm excited. Tell me more.
May is the month, and I think Mother's Day is actually a special date. I have to look back and be sure this is true. That might be Maxine's birthday.
Okay.
In May. And so May 10th, I'm going to be in Cleveland, Ohio, at a beautiful jazz club called Nighttown.
Sure.
And that's the debut of the Return of the Pint-Sized Songstress show. I'll be up there with
Mark
Strickland.
I wish you well.
Yeah,
great.
Thank you. We're coming right back to Pittsburgh to perform the show and debut it in Pittsburgh. At the City of Asylum, which
tell
is
them where it's at.
Beautiful venue. Alphabet City, the City of Asylum, in Pittsburgh's historic North Side.
Okay.
It's a wonderful, wonderful venue. They have great food and drink there. It's very intimate. And so we're excited to do the debut for Pittsburgh there. And that's going to, again, be May 17th, 8 o'clock p.m. And for other venues throughout the region, throughout the country, if they want a version of this show, we'd be happy to talk to them about bringing this show, you know, to their art centers or whatever to perform
sure.
it, shine a light on
her. Tell them how to contact you.
Yeah, shine a light on Maxine with the show. They can contact me easily if they go to the website, which is jessicaleejazz.com, Jessica L-E-E, jazz.com, or jessicaleesong, S-O-N-G.com. There's, you know, email there, jessicaleesong.com, jessica@jessicaleejazz.com.
Please contact Jessica Lee about the return of the Pint-Sized Songstress. You'll enjoy the show. She has many more songs to sing than the sample of songs that we've done today.
Yeah, and there'll be three categories, Maxine songs, a couple of those who she influenced, like Billie Holiday and Sarah Vaughan, and then some originals.
You can't beat it. Come out and see Jessica Lee live.
Yeah. Thank you, Al. And remembering and honoring Maxine Sullivan.
And thank you for doing this show. I'm glad I could produce this show. Thanks to Dave Cable on BPTV for putting out the Return of the Pint-Sized Songstress.
Thanks, Al.
Thank you for asking me to sing. It's mighty sweet of you, so let that music swing some of these days. You'll miss me, honey, some of these days. You'll feel so lonely. You'll miss my hugging. You'll miss my kissing. You'll miss me, honey, when you're away. I feel so lonely just for you, only for you, no, honey. You've had your way, and when you leave me, you know 'twill grieve me. You miss your little baby, yes, some of these days.